You're looking at the Corsair Crystal 280X RGB. The special thing about the case is that it only accommodates a Mini-ITX or a MicroATX motherboard. So there's no support for a full ATX motherboard on the inside. On the front, you get two RGB fans pre-installed, so that's why the 280X RGB name. While the 280X regular edition comes with regular fans installed on the front. There are also two variants in the 280X, black and white, and that's the same with the 280X RGB. As you can see, there are two slots, two fan slots on the top, so there you can install a 120 millimeter or a 140 millimeter fans, two of them. There are mounts for both. On the front, you can install two 120 millimeter fans. And there's no support for 140 millimeter fans on the front, so you won't be able to install a radiator as well, so you will be restricted to a 240 millimeter radiator on the front. On the bottom also, you get slots for two fans, 120 millimeters and 140 millimeters. However, if you want to utilize the bottom mount, you will have to use a Mini-ITX case, because as you can see, the MicroATX case is taking a lot of space. We aren't sure whether you can install two fans on the bottom if you are using a single GPU. This is something we'll have to test it out. But as Corsair is mentioning, that if you want to utilize the bottom mounts for any kind of fans or radiators, you'll have to use a Mini-ITX motherboard. The case has a dual chamber design, so on the front you have the core components, while on the other dual chamber, on the different chamber, you have all your storage devices and the PSU. There's a dust filter over here, so if I take it out, you can see that the PSU is installed over here, and there's another fan slot for your storage devices so that it doesn't get too hot inside. And since there are two screw holes, we can say that you can install a 120 millimeter or a 140 millimeter fan over here. So that's all from the Corsair 280X RGB.